Are you a senior who thinks strength training is only for the young and fit? Think again. Avoiding strength training is one of the deadliest mistakes you can make with your health as you age. Without regular training, your muscles are unable to catch any falls and you can end up with fractures, bedridden, living the worst possible painful life. In this video, I explore the mindset behind those elderly who avoid the gym and compare to those who've made it a priority and are dominating their old age. Then you get to decide which group you want to fall into.
I have older parents and I have told them multiple times to go to the gym, do resistance training and maintain their strength. But nothing has worked so far. So I wanted to understand, where is the root cause? Why aren't they going and doing any strength training? So I gave my father-in-law a call.
जब आपको उधर जिम लेके गए थे तो ज्वाइन क्यों नहीं किया
Thought process. There is an inherent mental block.
अच्छा.
Which is at this age why you are straining so much.
Yeah.
The mental block that is not that much essential.
It's not essential, okay.
What I am doing is okay.
Yes.
I can recover myself.
As you saw from the conversation that he mentioned that this is a mental block. They are afraid of going to the gym and getting injured. But what is the trade-off? There is a low likelihood that you'd go to a gym, a controlled environment, and if you find that you have a good trainer, a good support person, they might not let you get injured. They will train you how to do the exercises properly. But if you don't focus on your strength training and endure a fall, that would be much more serious of an injury and pretty much irreversible. In this same quest for understanding, what feels good to those elderly that actually go to the gym and work out, I met two wonderful ladies right here at my local gym.
So, Kathy, thank you so much for being here.
You're so welcome.
Can you tell me a little bit more about yourself and your fitness journey, how old you are, and why do you come work out?
Yes, I'm 64. I'm a young 64, and I think part of the reason that I have such good health is because I do exercise regularly, including weight training and or lifting weights and weight bearing using my own body weight in some of the exercises such as pull-ups and dips and things like that. So I started fairly young. I was very fortunate to be somewhat athletic, and I was very hyper as a kid. So in 2011, my husband and I actually bought a gym, and we bought it for the community because it had gone bankrupt. So in our attempt to get the gym up and running, I introduced my friend Susie here to actual weightlifting.
And so, Susie, can you share a little bit about yourself? Were you also as athletic as Kathy was?
Not in the same way as she was at all. I mean, I always just did the normal sports in school and boating and swimming a lot, good and that, but just general walking. And I was walking before breakfast a couple miles every morning before I did this, but I've never really did weight training before, and thanks to Kathy and her husband Wayne got me into it. And I'm pretty dedicated now because I know I need it, because I'm on the borderline for osteoporosis, and I'm not even osteopenic, but very small bones and susceptible breaking my bones, which I have. So this is wonderful, and I love working out.
Susie and Kathy are great friends, and they've been coming to this gym since 2011. That is 12 years together. Every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, they come to the gym, they weight train together. And I think that's where the secret sauce lies.
Before you met Kathy, was there any inhibitions in your mind to going to a gym and weight training, specifically weight training? Because I've heard many elderly say that they are afraid they're going to injure themselves with the weights.
I never was worried about that. It's just that, you know, kind of when you have enough time to even do this. Yeah. Sometimes you have more time now than when in the real working part of my life. But it was neat to have somebody to really show me that I know so well and wasn't going to overpower me with what to do.
So do you think that that was a big reason you stuck, because she was coming with you every day?
Yes, at the beginning, definitely. And then I felt comfortable with what she showed me to do in my routine and how I could alter it and whatever. So once I got in the rhythm of it, I have my Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and that's what I do. And I'm a scheduled person. So, and I love when she's in town, which is mostly, but when she's gone for a few months at a time, I'm very comfortable on my own.
That's amazing.
Yeah. That's such a great story.
Yeah, yeah, it is. So if we can do it, anybody can do it.
Exactly.
Especially me, not with
and
her.
It is, she is, you know, it is scary at first. Yeah. I think it is scary for people at first. They don't know what to do.
Yeah.
So start, you know, start slow. Start, just build a repetition. You know, do the same thing every day or every other day until you get it correct.
Right.
And then slowly add something. But it's just the act of getting up and getting, you know, getting it into the gym.
Right.
Or have your own hand weights at home, but doing it regularly, you'll see a big difference.
Kathy so very generously shared some of her beginner moves with us.
And we're going to pick a weight that you can do many repetitions for. We're going to just do four movements to start. So we'll do the regular dumbbell curl. So it'll be up and down, up, down. You can do 10 of those. And the next move is going to be just lateral arm raises. You can do 10 of these, 10 on each arm. Then we'll just do 5. But these are really good to just do every other day. And if you just do these 4 moves, you'll see a big difference after a short period of time. Next one is going to be just one weight. Put it in one hand over your head. Drop it down and go straight up. Gonna drop it down and go straight up. Down. Again, you're gonna do 10 of these. Yeah. And then the last one you'll do for your arms is called a kickback. When you go to the gym, people are looking at themselves in the mirror. And it's just so that they can get their posture correct. So a lot of times you want to make sure you're in good form when you do the exercise.
While editing this video, I showed some of these clips to my father-in-law. And here's what he had to say.
Over it, tricep press. Oh, amazing. It's amazing. I'm inspired.
Yes.
Oh, if they can do, I can also do it. And I will also do it.
Yes, that is the spirit.
Silly. Yes. Very inspiring.
It makes me so happy to have inspired him to take charge of his health at the age of 69. Yes, it's going to be hard, but don't let your limiting beliefs stop you from enjoying and thriving in your golden years. Find people who'll walk this path with you and be your cheerleaders, just as Kathy was for Susie, and you'll be making progress in no time. So share this video with one friend who's 70. Heck, share it with someone who's 20 and get stronger today. I also made a video about neuroscience-backed hacks that will give you lots of energy to do these workouts. So watch it next, and I'll see you next week. Thank you.